The ones who said the vax and the jab was the mark of the beast. How do they look now? How do they look now? And those who a few months ago, a couple years ago, a year ago, when the pandemic was going on, COVID, they said we're in the great tribulation, the four horsemen are riding, the seven last plagues are here, all this is going on. How do they look now? They look like idiots. They look ignorant. But Mike Dial was right all along. And Mike Dial is right now. And all those people were wrong. People today are so worried about being offended. Oh, that offends me. That offends me. You're an offense to me. Look, wake up. Quit being woke and wake up. Those who are woke over there across the river in Washington, up there in New York, those who think they're woke, they're spiritually broke, and they're morally bankrupt. Are you listening to me? You better forget about and stop worrying about being offended and start worrying about your offenses, your sins that offend God, the offended party, and that bring about your end. Now, that's good preaching right there. Today, I mentioned it a few moments ago. Let me give some more meat on the bone. Today we have lost. I want you to look at verse 29 of Luke 11. Well, actually, I like verse 23 first. Verse 23, Jesus said, "He that's not with me is against me." If you're not all in with Jesus, then you're against him. And he considers you an enemy. Are you all in? Are you with Jesus? Or are you with money and self and religion and this world? But down in verse 29, I want you to see what Jesus called his generation. He called them names. When the people were gathered thick together, he began to say, "This is an evil generation. They seek a sign." An evil generation. Jesus called them evil. Oh, that offends me. You call me evil, totally depraved, pagan, heathen. Jesus called them snakes. Jesus called them a generation of vipers. I'm not making... Jesus called them twice full more, the son of the devil. Jesus called them sons of Satan. Oh, ye of little faith. Don't be offended when a preacher like me preaches truth. Accept the truth and repent. You say the Bible doesn't preach repentance. Sure it does. Look at verse 32. "The men of Nineveh shall rise up in judgment with this generation and shall condemn it, for they repented at the preaching of Jonah." They repented at the preaching of Jonah. The Bible teaches repentance from sin. But today, because of sins of the pulpit, we need repentance in the pulpit and repentance in the pews. We need to come back to true repentance. We need to come back to a gospel of total commitment, consecration, dedication, and sanctification to God, where Jesus is Lord. Not lucre is Lord. Not lottery is Lord. Not liquor is Lord. Not taking license with licentiousness and lasciviousness, but Jesus is Lord. We have lost the here gospel. We have lost the "his return is near" gospel. We have lost the "fear God" gospel. And now we have the "see" gospel, the "sign" gospel, the "sight" gospel, the "have a beer" gospel, and the "do not fear" gospel. But Jesus says that is going to lead you to hell. Jesus Christ was far more a hellfire and brimstone preacher than Mike Dial will ever be. Did you hear what I just said? Jesus was far more a hellfire and brimstone preacher than Mike Dial will ever be. And Jesus went on to say in verse 34, "The light of the body is the eye. When your body is single, your whole body is full of light. But when thine eye is evil..." What are you looking at? What are you looking at? You're looking at porn. You're looking at hookup sites, hookup apps, sports, filthy TV, filthy movies, screens, scantily clad women. What are you looking at? When your eye is evil. Evil. Your body is full of darkness. Take heed, therefore, that the light which is in thee be not darkness. And that is what is going on today. We call it light, but it's darkness. All these images on these screens, Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, Satan's media, social media, we call it light. TV, the movies, that's not light. It is Lucifer's light. It is Lucifer's light. It is false. It is sin. It is wrong. It is darkness and it is evil. And I call it out. And I call it out. And somebody said, you might lose it all. I've already lost it all. When you've already lost it all, you got nothing else to lose. You've already lost. I'm the bucket list event. You've already lost it all. Nobody invites me to preach. America's pastors hate Mike Dial. Nobody sends me an offering. They don't want to send me an offering. Why? Because my preaching convicts them of their sin. And they hate me. And I'm persecuted. But thank God Paul told Timothy, all who live godly in Christ Jesus shall be persecuted. They don't persecute Joel Osteen. They don't persecute Stephen Furtick or Rick Warren, but they persecute Mike Dial. They don't persecute Matt and Lori Crouch, but they persecute Mike Dial. They don't persecute Joseph Prince, but they persecute. They don't persecute Joyce Meyer, but they persecute Mike Dial. Now you think about what I just said. You need to forget about your profession and making money. You need to forget about your being a professional, and you need to focus on your profession of faith. You need to forget about your career or cash and find your calling, confessing your sins, confessing Christ as Lord, and confessing the cross of Calvary. Some people are under the mistaken impression that they're only responsible to God for what they do in their private discretionary time. In other words, if what I do or study at school is a sin, I'm absolved of responsibility. If my boss at work tells me to do something and my job is sinful, that I'm not responsible. Yes, you are. You better repent of that nonsense. Look, work sins are sin too. Online sin and lying is sin too. If you're lying online about anything, you are on a line to the lake of fire. For God to be your God, money cannot be your God. Trans is transgression, and that's all I can say there. Now, I preached my pen videos, or billions will die, because Revelation chapter 9, getting very serious for a moment, says a third of the world's population will die in the tribulation. But recently I've added a few more points to that. Billions also lie about their sin. Billions also deny their sin, and as a result, billions will fry in hell. So when I put that together, I thought, that's very serious. We need to put some levity, but hell's not a laughing matter. Hell's not a joke. But so billions will die and billions will fry in hell. How do we lighten the mood? Would you like fries with that? Come on. McDonald's says billions and billions served. Would you like fries with that? Would you like fries with that? I love preaching on TikTok, and I do my best to abide within what they call the community standards, and I've done a good job lately. I've been behaving. So TikTok famously and correctly has community standards. Well, let me ask you a few questions. What about Christian standards? What about church standards? And what about Christ standards? How are we to act in church? How are we to live? Can today's modern Christians and megachurches and man-created worship centers and today's new Christ, can they no longer take a stand on anything? The church doesn't take a stand, so she's fallen. I've fallen and I can't get up. I've fallen and I can't get up like Joe Biden. I've fallen and I can't get up. I'm like the little Wendy's lady when I look at today's gospel. Where's the beef? Where's the beef? Look, the Bible says, having done all to stand, stand.